So, hello and welcome UGA Call of Division Playoffs Quarterfinals. Not like last season where we started with the semifinals. This week, this time we have to play the quarterfinals versus Shoken Soul. We played them in week 6 actually and won 2-1 versus Shona. However, she's not able to play. They are not able to play. And so I play Kentakyu. I know Kentakyu. Not personal, but I know, like, I watch this YouTube stuff from time to time, but we haven't played once, and now we played 2 times in a row. First time this week in the UGA and next week in the VDL as well. So let's see how it goes. Pokemon wise, we have nearly the same Pokemon as in week 6, however I changed some stuff. I expect Kentakyu to bring pretty much the same Pokemon, like maybe with other movesets, but I think like Pokemon wise the matchup was super even, and I think both sides brought the optimal, nearly the optimal Pokemon. Like, I don't think Cryogonal comes, Miltank doesn't make too much sense to me. Magneton, they didn't bring Magneton at all, and last week I, like, in week 6 I even brought Manectric. So they saw that I'm willing to counter that, so I don't think Magneton will come. What else do they, like, Gogeist could be an option, but I don't see it coming, honestly. I just think they will bring the same stuff with, like, other movements maybe. I swapped Blastoise from Special Blastoise to Physical AV. In week 6 I brought Physical AV Sally, it was fine, but it wasn't great, so I was like, I want some different Sally, so like I can play Blastoise with AV. And I think that's pretty good, because they brought like Mystic Fire and stuff like that to deal with Blastoise, but versus AV Blastoise for physical spread, this doesn't work. So I could see this being really good. We have enough speed, so we outspeed Charizard at +1 when we are in Tailwind. Max attack, rest into bulk. Waterfall, because it's our strongest physical option for the max cannonade. Max Quake to boost up our specialty, Max Hailstorm for Gourgeist and mainly Latios, and Aqua Jet for the crosshair that you may have already seen. And yeah, I think this is pretty much my best spring. I could have went for Reindish over Torrent, however I think Torrent is overall a little bit more useful. Once again we have Mian Shao, it's the same as in week 6, like Focus Sash, same speed, same spread, but I swapped Stone Edge for Rain Dance. Like, if they bring Shardyberry Charizard once again, Mian Shao Stone Edge is not good enough against that. And they brought Sunny Day, so I think Rain Dance on Mian Shao. I had Rain Dance on Manectric, but Manectric wasn't good in the matchup. Mian Shao is way better in the matchup, so I could see this being kinda good. Coaching has to stick, Cross Combat hits nearly everything on the team really good. And then the last slot was Quick Guard or Fake Out. Fake Out is overall a little bit more useful, like for example if Impedium Bleed I can just fake it out, I can fake out Latias, whatever. However, Quick Guard has the advantage that in case they have Impedium in the back, it's better for like the like they could have Thunder Wave and all stupid stuff, and I want to prevent that if possible, so I opted for Quick Guard. Maybe this bites me in the ass, we have to see. Yeah, next up we have Sally, this time Leftovers. It's once again my endgame versus Feeny and Urshifu. Complete, like, enough speed so we outspeed Latios when we are Untamed. Max HP, nearly full defense, like I have 4 attack, 4 special defense, rest into defense, and even defense boosting nature. To live as many hits from Urshifu as possible. We have Protect, Leech Seed so we can stall out Feeny, Heavy Slam for solid damage onto Feeny, Air Slash for like Urshifu. Heavy Slam does not enough. Air Slash after 1 or 2 cannonade spread, cannonade chips, it KOs Urshifu, and I think that's pretty beneficial. I could have went for different moves as my last option, but I need Air Slash for the Urshifu. And like, even if I don't go special attack dropping nature, it doesn't change any outcomes, so I was like, let's just go for that. Exactly the same multicode as in week 6, I see no reason to change it, but we will still take the hit from Madsdale. Same spread, protect, tailwind, moonblast, beat up, pretty self-explanatory. Absolutely the same Arcanine, like, they most likely would expect it, but it's so good against them, so I see no reason to change it up. Same speed stat as for Blastoise, Blastoise is 1 point faster, so I don't speed type with my own Pokemon. Enough attack so I can one-shot Mudsdale if I'm boosted up, and yeah. And the addition, we have Crossile over Manectric this time. Manectric was really useless. And Crossile gives me another answer to like Latios, Charizard, and Fini. All of them were kind of troublesome. And like Crossile gives me another mode, which makes maybe lead, like maybe think like, oh, I don't want to lead Latios, Charizard because this loses to Crossile. Weakness policy for the Aqua Jet setup. Enough speed so I outspeed Latios when my weak armor got procced. And yeah, max attack, rest into bulk. Yeah, then we have Protect, pretty self-explanatory. Rock Wrecker, because it's like, it's always the question if you go for Rock Wrecker or Rock Slide. Like Rock Slide is better outside of Dynamax, but Rock Wrecker is so much stronger in Dynamax. Like 130 to 150 is so much if you, like it will step it's 30 base for difference. That's so big. Axes are mainly for Latios and Solar Blade for Fini and Mudsdale. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I just message Kentucky the code and then we can start. I don't know what I want to lead. I have plenty of options. Like the most obvious would be me and Shao Blastoise. The thing is if they lead like Latios Charizard and they have Bulldoze Airstream, I lose my, like I feel Bulldoze on Latios a lot next to Charizard. I could see that being pretty, I don't know if they think about it, but that's definitely an option. Also they could switch Charizard out into like Fini. But that wouldn't be as much of a problem because like Fini is not as big of a threat as it cannot go for boosted Max Geysers in the rain versus Sally. Like Sally always wins versus it. Yeah, we have to see what they bring. Good luck, have fun to Kentuckio. Hopefully our first match will be a great one. And yeah, we have to win in order to keep our mission to defend the title. But this won't be easy. Like, this matchup is pretty even. Like, it's really, really even. Let's see, maybe it brings some completely wild stuff. I have absolutely no idea. I don't expect it, but you never know. I thought a lot about if I could change stuff, and I absolutely could, but I think, like I don't want to play this mind game. They could probably know, yeah, he will change stuff, like we know what he brought, etc, etc. But I'm just like, well, I changed a little bit, but not too much because it worked. Like, I don't have to make a completely new team when I think what I have is the best, you know? Like, sometimes it doesn't matter if your opponent knows what you're running. If that's the best you have, go for it. And I think that's my best shot. Like, I don't think Mother Months would be super helpful here. Okay, let's see. I expect I want to know if Latias has Baldos. Okay, They have magneton this time. What's that impedance? So Quickcut is kinda useless, unfortunately. But this means my cross ammo is way better. I mean, magneton is a problem for crosser. For sure. That's definitely a problem for crosser. But would you really like? I could have Max Quake. Oh, Max Quake would be great. But I don't have it. But they don't know that I don't have Max Quake on it. And if they lead Magneton, I could still Dynamax Blastoise. I honestly kinda like that. What do we bring in the bag? I think Wimmy is good for speed control. Maybe we bring these two in the end. We have to see. Wimmy is just too passive, and if I go Wimmy Stealer, Magneton could be a real issue. I wish I had Max Quake on Crosser. Charizard Lati, okay, that's good. That's really good for me. Do we Dynamax Crosser? They have Switch Sense for Max Bug. But if I don't Dynamax, I could die to Charizard. But if they, like, would they stay with Charizard here is my question. I don't think they will. And if I KO Lati, I can still Dynamax Blastoise. I don't want to Dynamax here. I don't think they will stay in. I don't think Charizard will Dynamax here. In front of Crosser Blastoise, to be completely honest, it does. Maybe it's that Lati Dynamax? No, it is Charizard Dynamax. Maybe it goes for Max Guard Tailwind and as Focus Sash? Yeah, there's the Max Guard. Let's see, if he's... Is he Focus Sash? Focus Sash would be an issue, for sure. No, it's not Focus Sash, okay. I think Urshifu will come into Predator the Sucker Punch. Yeah. The thing is, I don't think it will KO me if I Dynamax. Maybe it will if he's focus, if he's banded. Actually, I could see. What if I just. Protect. And Max Cannonade. Cause I don't think he will Wicked Blow. I don't know if Sucker Punch KOs me if I Dynamax. Because I'm minus one defense. And if it does and I lose Crosser, that's really bad. Because then Charizard with Airstream support can just crush me. This way, I should get rid of Urshifu next turn. Overgrowth. Okay, that's fine, I guess. Yeah, it doesn't do much. I could switch Crossell out to have it for the late game, but I don't think I need to. I think I'm better off doubling Charizard. Am I? The problem is he can airstream here. I should have brought Rimi in the back. I think I have to get rid of Urshifu here. I could see him going for another Sucker Punch, honestly. And if he airstreams... Yeah. I don't know if Quake KOs and I don't want to risk it. I don't need a double protect, I just want to let Sucker Punch fail. Yeah, because even if he airstreams now, he has to choose a target next turn. Max Quake would have been good if it would KO, but I don't know that. And if I miss the KO on Urshifu, it's really bad. Like without the Grassy Terrain, I would definitely go for Max Quake. But with the Grassy Terrain recovery, I'm not 100% confident on getting the knockout. Let's see, is it Feeny? It's Magneton. I think we Rock Wrecker and Max Quake. Yeah, there was no air balloon. We should definitely take this with the AV. Yeah, easily. Okay, that's great. We can't go for the side Aqua Drive because we will KO ourselves. However, Charizard, like, it can't KO both mons. It really can't. Okay, game 1 went super well. It's not over by any means right now, but it's really, we're in a really good spot. Charizard should outspeed both. No, it didn't get the airstream. Yes, it did, right? Yes, it went for airstream in the last turn. Yeah, Crossel gets the KO! Crossel is so good. And it's not Shardy, but that's good to know. Okay. Great game one. My question is, how does he counter that? Magneton is faster than Blastoise, which is kinda concerning. If we would be faster, this would be amazing, but we aren't. I don't think he will lead Latias once again. Like, Latias was super terrible for him. I think we could Blastoise for sure once again. Blasters me and like if we expect him to not lead Lati, this is great. Because I get the coaching off, I get the max quake off. He could bait me and switch out into one of his ground immunities. I mean, Magneton is kinda scary, but with these two I kinda cover for Magneton. We bring Whimsicott in the back for the speed control, I guess. Do we still go Sally in the end? Or is Arcanine better? I mean, Sally is solid. Sally is solid versus everything but Magneton and Charizard, and if I can eliminate them, I'm in a good spot. I could go Arcanine, but I'm feeling a little bit weak to Fiend if I go that route, honestly. He could, yeah, and he could Dynamax, Magneton gets Despec boost on Feeny. I think Sally's a little bit more safe. Magneton is not sturdy, Focus Sash or Shaka Berry, that's also good to know. So maybe it doesn't even live plus one Max Quake. Lati Charizard once again. Okay guys, do we go for Rain Dance, Max Geyser into Charizard? Or do we go coaching Hailstorm into Lati? Predicting the Max Guard. I'm kinda willing to play it like this. Yeah. Honestly, I should target on the Charizard with Sally in the back. Yeah, that's it. But if he max guards once again. Maybe they go max guys up. Maybe they go Sunny Day stuff once again. But then they go don't go Tailwind and I can. Tailwind next turn. Yeah, either way I get rid of the sun, if they set off the sun. And I should get rid of Lati. Like they max guarded last game. So maybe they max guard once again. I don't know that. I'm more willing to think that Lati does not have protect than Charizard going for max guard. Okay. Oh, the Lati is slower. That's interesting. I was like, maybe they went. It's even slower than Charizard. Okay, that's good to know for the upcoming games. Tailwind. Okay, we lose Mian Shao, but they lose Lati. And we get, and we can get Tailwind up as well. Wow, it lives. Hopefully it's not Berry. Berry would be kinda annoying. It is Berry, That's not ideal. Maybe it doesn't have Sunny Day. Cause I could go Wimmy, get up the Tailwind, and Max Geyser the Charizard, Max Cannonade Charizard. But if he sets the Sun, that's not good. I really needed that KO. I didn't think that he would lead the same stuff once again. Next game I will lead Crosser. I know that he still outspeeds me, but it's not like Whimsicott gets anything else off. I don't think he's Sunny Day because Charizard is faster than Delati, and it wouldn't make much sense to me. Yeah. Get plus one cannonade off. This won't KO, I think. Oh, he's special, okay. So definitely won't KO. But it will do good amount. Yeah, that's a good amount. Do we get a KO on Lati? Okay. If he brings in Magneton, I max Quaker. Because I should outspeed, because I have Tailwind up as well. No, I don't outspeed, because he has Tailwind up as well. Yeah. It's Urshifu. I think I cannonade the Urshifu. Because Charizard, I could see Charizard max guarding. If it doesn't max guard, I can still Aqua Jet is next turn. You know? And we go protect Sally. Because I don't want to eat up Massive Wildfire in case he goes for that. Okay, doesn't protect. I still think I have to target on the Urshifu regardless. If he has Magneton in the back or Fini, we are kind of... I think he wins this either way because Blastoise only wins versus Mudsdale and I don't see him having Mudsdale in the back. The good thing is Urshifu goes down, Charizard is in range of Aqua Jet. But I think it's Magneton in the back, and then I'm kinda screwed. I mean, I could Earthquake. If it's Fini, I'm in a bad spot. It's Fini. I don't think I can beat that down. Wildfire comes before Cannonade, right? Before Leftovers and stuff like that, right? How many turns of Cannonade are left? Two. I still think I have to target on Charizard. With an Aqua Jet. Do we just Savvy Slam Fini for damage? I think we do. It might even outspeed us. Actually, it most likely will outspeed us. Okay, nothing we could have done about that. Aqua Jet hopefully KOs. But I don't... Yeah, maybe we win the 1v1 versus Fini because we have plus 1. But the problem is Wildfire shipping down my Blastoise, so maybe that's not possible. But we are faster than Fini. The 89 does 36. I don't think we... No, he has two turns of Wildfire left, right? Yeah, and yeah, so we go down with two Wildfires. Yeah, we can't win this. Oh, it's the last turn of Wildfire. Maybe then it's possible. But I don't think Earthquake will do enough. And I could see like with Moonblast, with Moonblast we should go down to Wildfire anyways. And we don't do enough damage. Yeah, we go down. Okay, him having partial berry is good to know. Still don't know the item on the Urshifu. I just don't know if Choice Band KOs Crosser. Could Crosser Dynamax. Okay, what do we, like, what do we bring Pokemon wise? Where's Rostar? There it is. Does he lead with the same stuff once again? Don't know. I have to get rid of Charizard, then Sally should be fine. So maybe Crossle, Blastoise. Sally in the back. Could also go Arcanine. Arcanine wouldn't be too bad. Actually, what does he do if I bring Arcanine? I just Tailwind, get rid of Lati. Actually, Arcanine is really solid here, right? And then we could have Blastoise Crosser in the back. Maybe? Why do I bring Blastoise Crosser in the back? Sally would make more sense. Yeah, yeah, maybe this wasn't the smartest idea I had, because... Okay, Fini Lati. It's Telepathy Fini as well. Could just Tailwind play rough, honestly. What does he switch on? He has switch ins. Most likely Charizard in the back. But he can't really let me, like, he can't really risk me Dynamaxing and KO'ing Fini, I guess. So maybe this is also a play. I don't know if I KO play buff, but if I do, it's great. Max Dapper could have KO'd. I'm not too confident on that. Does he Coal Mine here? Coal Mining would be wild. Gold. I could beat up White Charge, but he should know that. And if he just protects Psychic, I'm in a bad spot. Shouldn't KO. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, because Lati should not speed Arcanine. Coal mine, that's not too ideal. Especially since we don't have Sally in the back. Turn 1 Max would have been game winning on Arcanine, because we should have KO'd Lati this way. He doesn't protect, that's really good. And he's not Rockenberry, we know that. Solid damage. Oh, we don't even die, that's kinda good. I mean, if Chavez comes in, that's bad. Yeah, actually, I would have preferred to die here. Actually, I would have really liked to get knocked out here. Yeah, that's not ideal. Cause Chavez that also speeds Arcanine. I think we tried to get a wild charge off. The problem is you can just airstream Wimmy. I need a second Tailwind. Do I need Crossle anymore? I don't think so. I think I kinda can sack Crossle. I want a second Tailwind. Maybe that's not the best idea. The problem is he could just airstream Wimmy and it will kill me through Protect. Oh, you know what I could have done? Protecting Arcanine to play around the score. I don't know about that. The good thing is we get the Dynamax advantage. Kefini protects. Okay, that's good. Crosser going down is kinda good for me. Cause Charizard won't outspeed me if I get the Tailwind up. Or Arcanine, at least not on the first turn. He has to have Urshi from the back, right? I think I still have to target Feeny. I could target Charizard to put in range of Cannonade. But Charizard is not the threat to Blastoise, Feeny is. Threat to Blastoise. Oh, come on! That's terrible. This was so... such a bad play of him. I shouldn't... I got a double protection one, a game one as well, but my double protect was absolutely not needed. This is so bad. Cause now Charizard and Feeny... Feeny does not speed, but Charizard does speed. Getting rid of Feeny would have been really helpful. That's so bad. I really needed to KO Feeny. Because that's an answer to Blastoise. Ah, that's so bad. That's so, so bad. If he doesn't get the double protect, we just win. Straight up. The problem is I don't get through these Pokemon quick enough, and then he has Urshifu on the back. I can't win this, I think, because I don't do enough damage to Urshifu. Like, I was like, if you stay in with Feeny, I KO it. If you switch out into Urshifu, fine, I put it in range of Cannonade. But now he KOs Blastoise, he KOs Arcanine, I can't KO either right now. He gets rid of my Dynamax turns, and then Urshifu in the endgame just finishes me off. Stupid double protect. I could have white charged Charizard as well, but Charizard is not the threat. Charizard is not the threat. I needed to KO Feeny. Yeah, now Feeny. Oh, that's a crit. No, it's not a crit. It doesn't matter. I can't get rid of Feeny quick enough. Yeah, next turn he just protects. Him outspeeding with everything now is also super bad. Stupid double protect. I hate this game so much from time to time. He just protects with both, right? Do I have to care about Charizard? Honestly, I don't really have to. I think I can and should kinda ignore Charizard and target on Feeny. Hopefully he doesn't double protect. I was close to target Charizard. And this would have been a good play in the end. Doesn't matter anyways because it's Urshifu in the back. I absolutely can't win this. Man, that's so annoying. I want to know if the max HS on Lati was a role in game 2, by the way. I need the Cannonade. I can't win this, let's be real. Like, yes, Urshifu 100% in the back, and I can't beat Urshifu. Watch him getting the burn. Yeah, of course. Of course. I know I'm once again a little bit salty, but come on, that's so getting kicked out of the league with something like this is so frustrating. Like without the double, I got the double protect in game one, but I didn't need it because he didn't target. Like he only targeted me with Sucker Punch anyways, and I only went for protect to block the Sucker Punch. Like I'm not went for the double protect. And here, like, as I said, like, if I get rid of Feeny, I just straight up win, you know. Because like Charizard and Urshifu cannot. Yeah. Now he gets a crit. I don't even get to know the last one. Jeez. GG's. We can talk to you. Like, it's not his fault for the double protect. Obviously, like, it was a good play out of for him. But it's just so annoying because if he doesn't get that, we KO Feeny and then we just win because we have two turns of three turns of Dynamax left with Blastoise, so we can just target on Urshifu and then win, because Charizard cannot be Blastoise with a Sword Vest and us having like Cannonade and Aqua Jet and stuff like that, we just win then. Obviously I could have played different by just Dynamaxing, targeting Lati, but I don't want to do this because if he switches out, I waste my Dynamax and I'm not even confident on that KOing, honestly. Because playoff did not do that much, and I don't think plus, like, it's close. Plus, like, Life Orb makes Sazen from Arcanine. I don't know if that's stronger than plus one Max Sazen from my Blastoise. I mean, Arcanine is more attack, but plus one is more of a boost than Life Orb, and Arcanine did not have max attack. So I think it's around the same. So I don't think I would have KO'd. Yeah, and if I just if I white charge Charizard instead of Feeny, I just lose because like then I don't target Feeny, and he protected the turn before, so it was not a bad play to target that Feeny. You know, I needed to target that, but I can't do anything about the double protect. If he doesn't get the double protect, I think everything else in game 3 was completely fine from both of us. Like, not maxing early was good on both sides. I can't believe that he went for the same read in game 2, honestly. Like, obviously you can say you didn't bring good mons in game 2, like Celestia was super useless in the endgame. Yeah, that's true. However, like, Crossfit wouldn't have helped that much in that position as well. I just needed a Feeny endgame, and Sally is a Feeny endgame. Like, game 2 was fine with losing. Like, I was not expecting the pressure berry, I was not expecting to miss the KO on Lati. Oh yeah, and like, game 3 was also a little bit, like, it was good that Arcanine survived, but it was bad at the same time, because I would have gotten the free switch in, which would have been kinda helpful. But in the end, because he got the double protect, Arcanine surviving was super useless for me. So, yeah, as I said, it isn't even match up, and yeah, we lost to 1 in 3 chance of him getting the double protect, basically. That's it for the UGA season. Good luck to everyone else, and have fun. See you in the next UGA season. I will try to get my title back. And yeah, guys, check out Kentakio's side of the match as well. I will link his channel. And I hopefully see you next week in the VDL to get my revenge versus him. Goodbye.